Glad to have you with us in the studio. I'm Reese Davis, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites.
We're live at Kyle Field, known as one of the most intimidating road venues in college football, thanks to the 12th man. Vincent is on the field to kick this one off, and everyone in the stadium is ready for this game to get started. He's to the 20. He gets out to about the 22-yard line. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. He's going to try and scramble. Tackle made at about the 35.
Well, this is a nice run for the first down by this quarterback. That makes it first and 10.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 35-yard line. Nice run, and he's brought down. Ball on a pitch out. He's at midfield. At the 30. They'll bring him down at the 17-yard line.
That always stings the defense to give up a big running play like that. They don't want to give up big chunks of yards on the ground.
So we've got a first down after a great running play. Stewart gets a carry right side. What a play to set him up with a first and goal.
What is going on with his defense? I mean, don't get me wrong. The offense is doing a nice job with first downs, and they're executing well. But the defense is just letting them maintain possession and move the ball right down the field. They've got to try to change things up with their scheme. Be more aggressive. Attack. Do some things to change it up. Take some risks.
That's good for a gain of 7 yards. That brings up second and goal.
From the 1 yard line, second down. They hand it off. Touchdown, Colorado! And he converts the extra point. Time for an update from the studio. Reese, what have you got?
The Demon Deacons came into the game ranked 9th. After the bitterly disappointing loss, how far will the Bolsters move them down? Who in the world saw this one coming? Not me. A major upset is done. The Broncos cruise by 19.
Thanks, Reese. 7-0 game here. Looks like they're ready for the kick.
Harris deep to return.
Martindale fields at the goal line. Across the 30. He's pushed out of bounds.
At about the 39-yard line.
Texas A&M's got some new faces on the roster that they're expecting some big things from, partner. And, you know, that's what's great about college football. New faces every year, unexpected stars, and the newcomers that kind of splash onto the scene. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. Caught, the defense lays him out. Well, we got a new quarterback in there. You have to wonder not only how will he do, but what does this do to the starter's psyche? So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, five wide receivers in the formation. They make the stop, the 36-yard line.
When you're running the ball for big chunks of yards like that, you've got something working.
Around the 26-yard line.
Now that's how you run a corner route. He exploded out of his cut and beat the man coverage for a new set of downs.
First and 10, ball on the 26-yard line. And he's taken down
right around the 24-yard line.
2 yards. That brings up second and 9.
There's a very impressive open field tackle. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 15. There's a strike complete. He's down.
That makes it second and 6.
Run there. Harris comes away with 5 yards on the carry.
That'll make it third and one.
Here's the 8th play of the series. Brought down around the 3-yard line. First down, and they are very close to tying this thing up. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with 5 wideouts. Tackle around the 1-yard line. So the designed quarterback run goes for about 3 yards on the play.
Second and goal.
Here's play number 10 on the drive. Touchdown, Aggies.
Great job of finding the space to run and just bursting in for 6.
They'll line up for the extra point in an attempt to tie the game. And he tacks on the extra point. So a 10-play, 60-yard drive, and they get it in for 7.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
They line up to kick this one away. He's to the 20. At the 30. Tackle made at the 30. Raymond got the first of what should be many tackles to come. He's a heck of a player. Really explosive and quick. A sure tackler, as you can see on that one.
Now, I think this defense right now needs somebody to try to lift up their spirits. They seem to really be just just out there kind of going through the motions. And I think the last time they were out there where they gave up such a long drive has had an impact and an effect negatively on the psyche of this defense.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 30. With the pass, incomplete.
As a defender, you want to keep your hands up. Maybe you can come away with a pick or at least deflect the ball.
Always a noisy place to play and tough on the offense. Receiver and it's knocked away.
That would have been pretty remarkable if he'd managed to hold on to the ball after taking a shot like that.
Gray is waiting for the snap. He's to the 40. He's taken down at the 42. Every drive's important in a tie game. I look for both sides to come out with some urgency. A quarterback in the gun with five receivers. He's taken down at the 42-yard line. No gain on the play. So at the end of one, we're even at seven in this one. We can only hope the second quarter is as good as the first. Tight ball game, folks.
Hey, hey, hey. Let's go, let's go. Here we got Mike, number
53. Third down, and they need to get it inside the 48. There's a strike complete, and he's tackled around the 47-yard line. Moves up in the pocket, and down he goes.
Brad, not only did they give up a sack here, but their quarterback just got hit and hit hard. If I'm an offensive coordinator, especially an offensive line coach, I'm getting a hold of my offensive line, making sure these guys are on the same page, and they've got to take more pride in taking care of their quarterback than that play right there.
They find themselves in a hole here after that sack. It's second and long. Halfback's got it on the quick throw. And down he goes at the 48.
That's a gain of one on the play. That makes it third and 15.
Here we go. Let's go, let's go. Here we got Mike, number 53. Mike, 53.
Going deep. Found his man. Touchdown, Texas A&M. Texas A&M's been telling anybody that would listen that this kid really has what it takes to be a star. He's always going to remember that first touchdown. I'm sure he's going to have a lot more. Great moment, though, for him and his family. He makes the PAT. A six-play, 59-yard drive. And they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
This quarterback has really demonstrated a tremendous amount of ability and leadership today. I'd be very surprised if he didn't continue to play well.
Texas A&M is lining up to kick this one off. Raymond from the three. Tackle at the 29. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Strike to his receiver, no good.
Well, that was clearly a poor read on somebody's part. And the bad news is there was no defender around. If the pass was anywhere near him, it could have gone for a big play.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 29-yard line. Here's a screen pass. Gets it to the back. He gets hit out of bounds.
Right around the 36-yard line.
That makes it 33.
The crowd at this stadium, always a factor in a football game. Nearly intercepted. And watch out, they're going to bring the heat right here. And he's tackled at the 36. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes.
Texas A&M
is up a score. They'll knock him down for a loss.
Well, give the defense all the credit here. They had that one snuffed out from the start. It could have been an even bigger loss.
It's second down, 12 to go.
Ball on their own 35. Made at the 44.
That'll bring up third and two.
Larry. He makes his way to about the 45. It's first and 10.
Ball on the 45.
Quick throw. And he's leveled at the 40-yard line.
Johnson thinks he's at the 40-yard line. That brings him second and 5.
So the Aggies will use their first time out of the half. He makes it to the 38-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 2 yards. Third down.
Third down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. He's into the open field. Good outside run there. Texas A&M is up by a touchdown. They'll bring him down at the 19.
Here's the true test of a quarterback at any level. Can they make a good throw under pressure when one or two or three guys are coming right at him? I think this young passer has proven that, yes, he can.
Tackle outside after a nice pickup. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. In the shotgun and five wideouts. He's got it, touchdown. The extra point. Let's go to the studio for this Reese Davis update.
It's good on Rocky Top as we check in Knoxville. And for Virginia Tech, they're having all kinds of trouble so far. Tennessee leads it 14-7.
Two touchdown ball game here, Reese, 21-7. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Nice kick, plenty of distance. He's to the 20, and down he goes at the 22.
And here we go with the offense ready to get things going again. Now he tries to buy some time. And they bring him down for a sack on the play.
You can't take sacks like that as a quarterback. You just can't. If you can't find a receiver, get out of the pocket and throw the ball away.
Second and 11 coming up now. Ball on the 22. They come out in a five-wide set. It out to his receiver in a hurry. He's out to the 30, and they make the stop
at about the 37-yard line. We've played a half of football.
Texas A&M leads it 21-7.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half. Perhaps the most important statistic in any football game is turnover margin. I once had a wise coach tell me that the football was so important they named the game after it. Whatever that means. I think it means that you're not supposed to let it get away from you and give it to the other team. And so far, both of these offenses have done a great job of that.
No doubt. And most games are lost, not won. And it's because of the turnover differential. And you can look at the stats when you say that every single time. But, you know, both teams doing a good job taking care of it. Both offenses executing and still calling a game, still scoring points, still putting up good numbers, but at the same time taking care of the pigskin. And they better value that thing because, yeah, you give it away and bad things happen.
David's ready to get back on that couch, get the remote, get all the games dialed up to watch what's going on around the country. Time to get you back for your second half. Brad and Kirk ready to roll.
All right, Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half. He's to the 20. The quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. Finds his man and they take him down immediately. And they get 5 yards from that completion.
You don't have to go deep every play to be successful. They got 5 yards on the play, and that's always a good game.
It's second down, six to go. Ball on their own 32. Tackled for a loss.
Good discipline here by the defense, stringing the option out and plugging the running lanes. That moved them back.
Hit and taken down. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 39-yard line. Fires it out. He's tackled at the 46. Six-yard line. First down. Plenty of time in the pocket, and he tackles him hard at the 46-yard line.
That's a loss of 80 yards. That'll make it second and long.
So the sack makes this a second and long.
Let's go. And we got Mike, number 53.
He goes out of bounds at the 49.
That makes it 3rd and 15.
Would have been a big play by the defense. He can't hold it. Gray is the punter.
It always astonishes me how quickly the field shrinks for a returner. You're looking up at the ball, and suddenly, there's what looks like 100 guys bearing down on top of you.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. Hall gets 7 yards on the play.
That'll bring up second and 3.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. The right side doesn't get much. Good tackle.
Those linebackers do a great job of stopping the run, but they need to be careful of the play action pass. You can easily get fooled and give up some big yards through the air.
They can't hear a thing down there.
The offense here picks up a first down by running the football, and I really think that they gave the quarterback there an option at the line of scrimmage to run or to pass, depending on what he saw from the defense. The defense that time looked to be out of position. I think they were anticipating a pass. Quarterback recognized that, made the check at the line, and they were able to run the football for a first down.
Catches it, and that's all. A 7-yard gain that time from the play-action pass completion.
That'll make it 2nd and 4.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down. They run it left. Taken down as he works the left for a nice gain.
Gain of 4 yards. First down.
At the 47. Maybe a yard on that draw play.
That brings up 2nd and 9.
Second down and 9 to go. Ball on the 47-yard line. He's on the run. And he's taken down at about the 47-yard line.
That makes it 3rd and 3.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. Now we'll see how the backup can do after that injury. Throws it out and it falls incomplete. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. You know they'd like to do something a little more than they did on their last drive when they had to punt the ball away. Quick pass brought down at the 22-yard line.
That makes it 2nd and 8.
2nd down, 8 yards to go. Ball on their own 22.
All day, just like that. Just like that.
He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line.
That's a gain of 1 on the play.
That's 3 down and 1 to go. Texas A&M's in front by 14.
Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number four.
Nothing clicking there. Let's see if they can make a few adjustments before their next series.
That brings us fourth and seven.
Raymond awaiting the return. He's got the corner. He's tackled at the 45. He showed a good burst there.
The offense takes the field again. They were forced to punt their last time out. Hand off, and he's met immediately. It's second down and 11 to go. Ball on the 47. Complete. He's got space to work. He's taken down around the 35-yard line.
But if this defense keeps taking chances with these blitzes, sure, they may get to the quarterback once in a while, but they also are giving up some big plays like that one right there.
And he's tackled
around the 22-yard line. From the 22-yard line, first down.
Gets out to about the 20, and he gets a yard on the run.
Good job by the junior linebacker to read the run and limit the play to a short gain.
At the 10.
First down.
From the 10-yard line, it's first down. He scrambled. Tackle made at the 3-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 7 yards. That'll bring up second and 3.
And the goal line defense digging in here.
Puts on a move. Touchdown. Nice run and a score by the halfback.
And a nice call by the coach there. Just give it to your main man anytime you're near the goal line.
And he hits the PAT.
Time for an update from the studio. Reese, what have you got?
The Hokies entered the day ranked 4th. That is now in the past tense. How far will they fall? And for Tennessee, they've won 2 straight. And for Jenkins, an outstanding performance with 3 touchdowns on the ground. Tennessee gets the win by 7. In other games, the Seminoles were ranked number 6. They hope that performance will move them up in the poll. And for FSU, they've won 2 straight. Florida State wins it 30-21.
Wow. You can feel the shockwave caused by that upset all the way to our game.
He really got a hold of that kick. Gray, ready to kick. He's to the 20. Tackle made at the 25.
A score here might effectively end this one. Just under 3 to go in regulation. There's a strike complete. And he's level at the 45-yard line.
He made a really good move at the line of scrimmage. Sometimes all you need to do is throw off the defender's timing just a little bit at the start of the play.
First and 10. Ball on the 45.
Quick strike to the... They'll bring him down right around the 44-yard line.
This passing game can be very effective if you don't get enough pressure on the quarterback. They use their personnel well and can be very tough to defend.
Here's a quick throw. Catches it, and he's looking for more. He's pushed out of bounds at the 16-yard line. The Buffaloes are going to call their second timeout. From the 16-yard line, first down. He fights forward to about the 16. The running back gets a yard, maybe less.
This guy is very physical, and he does a good job of taking on blockers.
Slings it. Nice play to set up first and goal. Texas A&M, it's first and goal, and they've got a chance to get a two-score lead here. They come out in an empty backfield. Here's the call from the referee. Splits the uprights with the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. I'm capture that touchdown, and their last possession's given them some confidence. But let's see if that carries them back down the field.
So much of the passing game is about the timing between the quarterback and his wide receivers. And right now with this offense, they are in sync, and really the timing and execution is flawless.
And that play could have gone for six.
Oh, boy, you're right. And all week long, this secondary did a lot of talking about how they were going to dominate these receivers. I think this is time that they step up and prove it on the field. Forget about talking trash. Let's see how they react after giving up that big play.
He's looking for six. That close to being intercepted.
This is a very well-coached defense. They know to get their hands up in the air and to try to knock down passes.
From the 28-yard line, second down, just over a minute in the fourth quarter. Steps out of bounds at the 26. That's a gain of 2 yards. That'll bring up third and 8. Always a noisy place to play and tough on the offense. Quick run, almost intercepted.
Pratty drops the ball here. I don't know if he's starting to peek downfield and think about the return or what, but that ball's right in his hands. He just dropped it.
And it's the offense that takes the field on fourth down. Well, that one should do it. A fourth down stop here late in the fourth quarter, and that should be the nail in the coffin in this game.
It's always a gamble going for it with so many yards to come up with. But when you're behind, sometimes you have to take risks to get back into a ball game.
The offense was able to punch it in the end zone on that last drive. They'll come back out looking for more of the same.
It was a really nice drive too, Brad. The quarterback got into a nice rhythm and did a good job of picking apart the defense.
Second down, about 12 yards to go. Ball on their own 24. Takes it right and brought down right away. That brings us 3-12. And this one's all but wrapped up. So the Aggies with a victory, 28-14. That does it for this edition of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.